Hello, I'm Ambassador Milan Verveer. As the United States' first ever ambassador at large for global women's issues for the last 3 years, I have been privileged to work to advance progress for women and girls around the world. Gender equality is both the right thing to do, the fundamental thing, and the smart thing. Every woman and girl deserves to be respected and to have her rights protected, including access to health and education, and to be free from violence. All around the world, I have met many inspiring advocates who are on the front lines working to prevent the HIV infection, providing treatment and care, addressing gender equality, and making a profound difference. Gathering together as a global community of diverse stakeholders, including academics, practitioners, civil society participants, policymakers, multilateral associates, journalists, young people, private sector corporations, and people living with AIDS, we must highlight the critical role of women and girls and the importance of gender equality in turning back the tide on HIV. Women and girls bear a disproportionate burden of ill health. Globally, AIDS is the leading cause of death for women of reproductive age. And women and girls represent 60% of people living with HIV in sub-Saharan Africa. Besides having a public health epidemic, HIV/AIDS is also a social issue that impacts men and women differently. And it's an issue linked with and affected by gender inequality. Gender-based violence, for example, itself is a global epidemic. It fosters the spread of HIV by limiting one's ability to negotiate safe sexual practices, disclose HIV status, and access services. Studies indicate that women who have experienced violence may be up to 3 times more likely to contract HIV than those who have not. Our success in fighting this epidemic is tied to our ability to recognize and respond to the reality of gender disparities. PEPFAR's work on addressing gender inequality is an exemplary effort to respond to some of the most serious health needs of women and girls. And I applaud their dedication to addressing the links between gender-based violence and HIV, as well as the investments that PEPFAR has made in this arena. My office and PEPFAR have recently launched a joint initiative to support civil society organizations which are working to prevent and respond to gender-based violence, as well as ensure HIV prevention, treatment, and care. Through this partnership, we will provide over $4.6 million in small grants to grassroots organizations and countries with a PEPFAR presence. We will leverage our respective platforms in the field and create links to address the drivers of both violence and HIV. Without integrating a gender lens through our HIV prevention, through our care programs and treatment programs, we will fall short in reaching our global targets in HIV prevention, treatment, and care, and achieving President Obama's commitment to an AIDS-free generation. Men and boys must also be a part of the solution. To advance women's rights, to turn the tide against both HIV and violence, we must engage all partners. Time and time again, Secretary Clinton makes the case that improving the health of women and girls improves health outcomes for their families, their communities, and creates more opportunities for economic growth and prosperity for everyone. After all, investing in the health of women and girls is not only the right thing to do, it is also the smartest investment we can make. And I wish you all the very best in your efforts.